Medical education is the training of our students to be competent physicians. Where scholarly projects comes in is really asking them to think about areas that are unexplored or insufficiently explored and actually advance the field. We try to give students a tremendous amount of leeway in their selection of projects, but what we found was that students with a particular passion could really make their education their own.
My scholarly project is a telemedicine in ophthalmology, and we are looking to research the prevalence of the four leading causes of blindness in ethnic minorities, and we do this by traveling to community gathering places to perform free eye exams. When I first entered the scholarly project program, I was very thrilled to be able to find this project with Dr. Alice Wadd and see that there were ways where we could enter the community as opposed to staying in academia.
Emory quickly got involved in my research. He learned the method, the skills, and applied it appropriately. You want an individual that's eager to learn. It's one of the most important characteristics in a mentee.
For my scholarly project, I'm working in the lab of Dr. Chung and Dr. Shen, focusing on detecting copy number variants of patients with congenital diaphragmatic hernia. Congenital diaphragmatic hernia is a common congenital defect, so I'm developing better tools to go about detecting this poorly understood class of genetic variation.
I'm working on a project with Dr. Catalozzi on curricular development, and we're focusing on developing an LGBTQ curriculum for the pediatric clerkship.
One of my fondest memories of Haley is really when she first met with me about her idea for this project. Her focus is really, let's make sure that we create materials where we can take the best care of patients. And that's why I know she's going to be a wonderful pediatrician, and that she'll continue doing impactful work.
I've been working on a project with Dr. Biviano and the Department of Cardiology. We're looking at the outcomes in patients who undergo transcatheter aortic valve replacement and subsequently develop atrial fibrillation.
I think the medical students develop a further appreciation for how difficult yet rewarding medical research is. And you have to have that passion to keep asking questions and saying to yourself, how can I make this better?
What has really impressed me about working with Dr. Viviano is how he's able to link his clinical observations to a research question.
For my scholarly project, I will be in Ghana conducting interviews with adolescents and young adults who have sickle cell disease and have transitioned from pediatric care to adult care. Being from there and seeing that there are a lot of illnesses that affect individuals who are both here in the U.S. and in Ghana got me interested, so that in the hopes that in the future I would be able to practice both here and in Ghana.
My thesis project is focused on understanding how hematopoietic stem cells are regulated by RNA modifications. Understanding how their function is regulated might help us develop therapies to improve their function after transplantation. My mentor, Dr. Ding, is a huge part of my graduate education. He guides all of my projects, and he's really helped me grow as a scientist.
My project is about studying sound transmission across the middle ear and the function of the tensor tympani, which is a small muscle inside of your middle ear. I am tensing and untensing this muscle and studying how that affects the fidelity of sound transmission. Before going to med school, I always wanted to be an inventor. Working in this engineering lab with Dr. Olsen, I'm using a laser. I'm also using a hook that I designed. This has been a great learning opportunity to not only learn what research is, but also to understand the challenges of research and to challenge myself to think critically all the time.
Being able to see students leave their own mark on P&S, on our curriculum, and being able to contribute their work and their scholarship to the general community has been incredibly powerful.